bloggers, a week or so after I got the bike, I did a gear video on what I had outfitted the bike with. I wanted to do a quick update and let you know about some of the things I really like, some of the things I totally regret buying. First off, these sunglasses. They look really nice, okay, real reflective and all. But I bought them because they have a camera in the bridge, and I was going to record my rides. Unfortunately, they only record for about 30 minutes tops, because it's an 8-gig card, and that's all it handles. Also, the microphone is dead center, and though it will pick up a voice fairly well, you kind of have to shout, and you look like a fool while you're out on your bike, at least. And it just picks up a lot of wind noise, really loud wind noise. So for the application I thought I was going to use, these guys turned out to be kind of a bust and a little bit of a regret, but I still can play around with them. I think I will keep them and just have some fun with them. So let's take a look at the bike and see what I really regret buying. Oh my God. Up first is this little guy. I did a review of this after I had it for about a week or so. It's supposed to be a horn with several different tones that you can select from. And after about 2 weeks, it just stopped working. You push the button and go, meow. It wasn't the batteries, it just died. It was a cheap $10 piece of junk, and it's garbage. So I replaced it with an air sound, and I'll show you that in a second. This trunk thought was really, really nice. A lot of room inside. The side pockets fold out and become pannier bags. It held a lot of room. I could put my fleece in the pannier bag when I didn't need it in the afternoons going home, but did need it in the morning. And then I hit a bump. I ran over a recessed manhole, and the straps broke on it. And I mean, they broke on it. You can see this one is simply through the plastic here. It's the stitching. No. So this was a bust. I get the rain pouch. I get to keep it. And I put in for a return, and then I realized it's a $15 bag, and it's going to cost me like $6 or $7 to return it. So I'm eating about $25 in purchases between those two items. I replaced the trunk with this one. Does not have pannier bags. A lot higher quality. I like the fact that this one has a bottle pocket on the back. You don't have to slip it in and try to get it out this way. And it's got a front strap on it. This little strap right here goes to the saddle, so it's very, very secure. A lot of room on the center area there, too. Made a boo-boo. Thought I was going to buy a lock for this, so I bought a standard luggage lock. And, of course, the cable is too big. I thought these were going to be standard zippers, but this is not. They're just nylon extensions here. And the cable doesn't fit in there, so I can find other uses for the lock. Not a big deal. Do like the U-lock and cable I got. I'm still using that to great satisfaction. The saddlebag. I got this thing because it has a cool LED panel in it, and it makes turn signals and all this cool stuff. And then I bought the trunk, and it blocks the saddlebag. Still using it for storage, but could have bought a $5 or $10 saddlebag instead of this one, which was about $35. Oh well, live and learn, live and learn. So what do I still use on this thing? Well, the cameras. I bought another one. I bought a Apeman GoPro knockoff. It was about $50 or $55, and then the price went down to $40. So I bought a second one. Now I've got one front and rear, all nice and mounted up. Love these lights. These little Stroom lights, I believe they're called, is the brand. Love those guys. Got so many lights on this thing. Fat guys leave presents under the bicycle. This is the air sound. I keep wanting to say zoomed, because that's how Shakespeare would say. It zooms. The air sound. This is the air bottle for it. Holds about 80 PSI. Refill it with a bicycle pump or compressor real easily. Got a little tube. Got it Velcroed. And then the horn is right here. Supposed to put out 115 decibels. People inside of cars with their windows up can still hear it. Used it just a couple of days ago to warn this guy who looked like he's about to run a stop sign and was looking at his cell phone that I was there. He looked up pretty quick, so I know he could hear that. There's the other camera mount. Oh, the camera mounts are upside down. That's cool.
The cameras actually have a rotate feature. You just hit rotate and they spin 180 degrees for recording and playback. It's really nice. Really, really nice. The phone holder, I'm still using. I like it a lot. All this stuff came from Amazon, by the way. I think if you search for phone holders on Amazon, this one comes up first as Amazon recommended Best Buy kind of thing. But it's really, really handy. So that is about it for regrets and things that I gear that I'm keeping and I like. Oh, the seat. This is a gel foam seat. And I got this free. I'll show you how. This bike over here is a little fixie, a single speed bike. My daughter was living about a mile from where she was working. I mean, she could have walked there if there was a bridge across the creek, but she had to go around. But she thought she was going to bicycle to work. And a friend of hers gave her this fixie, and she tried it one time, and it scared the living daylights out of her. So she just never used it again. And she left it here when she moved away to the Memphis area. So the gel seat was on that bicycle. And, it, of course, it's got a lot of wear on it already. It's used, obviously. But it sure does add a lot of padding to my rarely padded backside. Now, my backside has less padding on it because after 6 or 7 weeks of using this thing, I have lost 10 pounds. Yay! You're welcome. Less of me to put up with. I lost 10 pounds. Oh, a couple other things I did get since I made the gear video were these gaiters. These are really nice. Leg shield. More fluorescent yellow, more reflective strips. But these go on you at the knee to the calf and cover your pants. And as you can see, they keep grease and all that kind of stuff, chain lube, off of your pants. Really like those. I really, really like those. I've already ruined 3 pants before I got them. So 3 pair of pants shot before I got the gaiters. And, of course, my safety vest. I had not gotten this at the last video on gear, and I like it a whole lot. Now, it is a requirement where I ride on federal land that you have to have a safety reflective vest, but I wear it all the time because, hey, see and be seen, right? Where did they go? Oh, this thing. These are neodymium magnets in here, and I just tied a ribbon around them, so hopefully I'll keep this in my pocket and drop it out at the stoplight, and we'll see if that actually works. I've had people say it does and it doesn't. Thought I'd give it a try and see if that will help me set off some of the sensors to change the traffic lights, because the bicycle does not set the sensors off at a couple of intersections I have to commute through. And you can read about that on my blog, link in the doobly-doo, about how the city of Madison, Alabama said, eh, go ahead, break the law. It's all right. We don't want to come out and fix it. So that's some of the gear I got, some that I threw away, some that I've traded out, and I hope that gets you updated. I will be doing, very shortly, a review of the entire Rad Power Bike. I will call it my 1,000-kilometer review. I'm sitting at 597 miles right now. That's 960 kilometers. And not commuting this week because I'm working from home and calling insurance companies and all that kind of stuff. Wife is down in Birmingham for observation to see if she has a funky brain. So I have to... They don't have a release time for her, so I just kind of have to be here and be able to go if she calls and says, I'm done. So, working from home this week, didn't get to commute at all, but I will be commuting hopefully all 5 days next week. Weather looks great, and I should hit that 1,000-kilometer mark probably the first day, and then I will do a review of the entire bicycle and how it's working out for me. You, in the meantime, keep chasing the odd little happy